there was a backlog of problem cases. And what we were seeing is officers since 2008, since 2006, and earlier, had cases that were still pending adjudication within the administrative process. Through the commissioner's vision and the changes that have been made and the hard work of Rodney and the legal team, we have made that completely different. And the numbers reflect a smaller number of cases of officers opting to go to a trial, an increased number of cases where officers are agreeing to the penalty, and then a greater percentage of officers that do make it to the trial board are being found guilty of the allegations against them. That is through no small feat. But what we're going for is credibility. Credibility in our process, credibility in our ability to police ourselves, and credibility for us to identify misconduct within the ranks and then do the right things for the right reasons. And the numbers of officers found guilty at the trial board is increasing, not because of the change of philosophy or just find more people guilty. It's because the folks that are making it to the trial board is that less than 1% of officers who, for whatever reason, have committed some sort of misconduct that either have not changed their course of action due to training, and we have to now resort to the penalty. And the board members are realizing that. And it's important that we all work together to show to the community that we're serious about our legitimacy within the community and that we can't hold ourselves accountable. The commissioner has made that promise and we're sticking with it. It has not been easy to get here today, the state and the collective efforts of many of us working up here, the folks in internal affairs, the folks that work in patrol, and the leadership. But we are proud of the numbers show that we're going in the right direction. It's a constant reminder to us all of what the goal is and how to maintain our focus, our moral compass, if you will, in that right direction. With that, I thank you for your time, Mr. Chairman, and we would welcome the questions. Who has been trained and understands the overall issues, the goal, the standards set for the commissioner, and it's very simple. We are going to go, whether it's a trial board, whether it's an administrative review or a use of force, wherever the facts take us. We're going to look at the policies, the procedures, and the tactics that that officer employed leading up to, during, and immediately after. And within 72 hours, the police commissioner will have a very in-depth presentation with which the commissioner can identify any lapses in either the actions of the officers or the policies and procedures within the agency so that we do not have to wait 6 or 7 months for the completion. Now, this is a very preliminary look. We haven't interviewed the officers, but we've interviewed enough of the folks in the periphery where we can identify we have a lapse in training, a lapse in policy, and we can correct that real time so that we don't allow our officers to continue to make the same mistakes. When the use of force is then concluded, the commissioner will give recommendations based on a very thorough recommendation. Once that is completed, there will be an investigation document that is made public, and then we have volunteered, because that information is now open to the public, we will be also providing that presentation to the Civilian Review Board. We understand that it is new, but what we're saying is we are here to show and demonstrate what we're doing. We are transparent, and we want the Review Board to look at what we're doing, how we analyze our use of force, and how we render our decisions.
Thank you, sir. Let me be the first to say I appreciate the transparency. It's the one who's been in the last 7 years. I remember the department about transparency. So to see you guys take the full lead of yourself is something that I think you all should implement. My next question actually goes back to the Chief. Chief, if you could also provide the community, you listed out some of the ID or previous cases, 3 years, 2014.
face when I walked in. I brought in a new EEOC director for the police department to make it very clear that